Hey guys, this is Adam from Up to Level 6, and I'm going to try something that hopefully is not a bad idea for me to try. The other day on a Typhoon H that I've only flown a few times, I've got two, one that I've never opened and one that I've flown like twice. The second time, I brought it out to the park the other day with my daughter, and on the first attempt, it rolled over. It just rolled over when I tried to take off, and in doing so, I didn't know it at the time, but I lost connection to the gimbal. It was saying disconnected, and I didn't know why. But then I got home, and I noticed that there was a faceplate, and you could see that there's rails here. And these things match up to the bottom of the H. I'm gonna just show this real quick and then get out of the way. As you can see here, there's a plate right here that it matches up to this. See, those match up perfectly. By the way, I'm using, I have no cameraman here, so I'm gonna do my best to try and keep everything in frame, but mechanics is not my number one thing, so I'm going to pay most attention to what I'm doing rather than where I'm doing it. But I figured if I can do it, you can do it, so I'm gonna make a attempt here to try and show you how easy it is, because it certainly is if I can. I've watched a couple videos, most notably Taffy Crisp and his video and his son when they lost theirs. So what I need to do, you see those rails are off. Now they connect to, there's like a female version. I guess the male version, that's the female version. Right here, that's real thin. Now, this might take a while, but I'm gonna show you guys anyway. Also, it's wise after any sort of tumble to get new everything. Because there's nothing wrong really with these props, but you know, if you look at a couple of them, like here's one. See, it's got a tiny drop of a scuff mark on it, not much, but enough that, you know, for the little bit of money that it costs to replace props, I would advise it if you ever have any sort of tumble. So I ordered from a company called Terrestrial Imaging, which was suggested to me on by a man named Art Lewis on uniquepilots.com. I do not work for this company, and they don't even know that I was making this video when I ordered from them, and they were super nice. A guy named Christopher actually rushed the parts out to me even before I paid because he wanted to get them to me. I ordered them Monday, and today's Wednesday, put it that way. And here we are making the video. So, ordered a couple props, and this is the new mounting plate that you can see is nice and new. I couldn't find a video how to remove the dampers. What are they called? Dampers? See how little I know? They're called dampers. So I actually called Unique, whatever, and they told me, what they do is they just squeeze it and pull it down with their fingers. Taffy Crisp or whatever, his YouTube channel, which was what I watched in order to learn how to do this, he says to use a T2 Phillips, which, sorry Taffy, but that doesn't make sense because T2, anything measured with a T is these ones right here, which is the torque screws or the hexes. If it's a Phillips, then it's probably a Phillips 000 or even smaller. So I've got everything ready, including this, which is the only other, which is the smallest one I have, which is like an eyeglass. There's three screws that we need to access. Also, thank you to Nothing in Particular, is his YouTube channel, for giving me the idea on how to use either. He uses this like a twist tie. This is a long one. Like an 8-inch one. This is the one he used, so I did. It's got the longest one I could find. And by the way, these aren't as easy to find as you think. you think they're everywhere in your house. But it took me a few minutes to find one. I've seen since that a lot of people are using them for, with fishing line and whatnot. I might have to pause this video or edit it up so that, it doesn't take forever because, again, this is the first time I've done this. And I'm doing it live for the first time. So I'm not going to rush it in order to do it wrong because I certainly don't want to break my Sego 3 Plus because that's expensive while the piece that's broken is not. So for now, I'm gonna put this aside. So the first thing I need to do is remove this. There's like a plate here. I don't know what to call it, but it covers this part. I don't know what to call it. It's just a mounting plate. Well, the whole thing is a mounting plate, but be careful. You know, you want to be very careful when dealing with your Seago 3, because you know all of it is just so delicate. I personally don't like doing this. I would rather have someone else. But there you go. That part comes off real easy. So I'll put that aside for now. And now there's two. As you can see, there's two. I don't know what you call those things. The damper plate, or in the, I don't know what you call the things that make it not snap off. They're like, you know, there's two of those. I called Unit because I could not find a video on how to remove those. And since this is my first, they said just push it together and they just use their fingers and pull it out. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use pliers and push it down. Squeeze them together so that it's smaller than the hole. And pull it out. Okay, there we go. Just had to be, had to grow a pair and squeeze it a little harder than I was, and it worked just fine. By the way, I might also refer to the videos while I'm doing this, just to make me feel better. Actually, it's easier to just do with your hand. Nope, maybe not. There's the piece that I'm gonna remove, by the way, those three screws, which do look like Phillips rather than the X. You wanna be very, very careful at this point, because now I've got the wire, you know, those wires right there are very delicate. And if you break that stuff, then you got problems. And right below it is this. This is where the PCB board is. And that's the motherboard for the gimbal. You do not want to mess with that. So be very delicate. This is probably easier for people that know what they're doing. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do right now so that I'm not worrying about the... What I'm gonna do right now is I'm going to remove this part here so that I'm not putting stress on the wires. Actually, let me remove this first, because that one. Ah, done. Okay. Now, okay, so now I'm going to remove the three. Can you see those? The three, there's three screws there. And hopefully this size, which is a Phillips 000, is the right size, because it's the smallest one I have, other than there we go. Okay. Perfect. So the Phillips 000 is perfect for this. Works absolutely gorgeous. Screws right out. I'm not using magnetized ones because I just don't think it's necessary for three little screws. And if there's a chance that I might screw something up by using the magnets, then I don't want, you know, by using something magnetic, I don't want to, because this is a micro board and I don't like adding magnets to micro boards. So anyway, it will go back exactly like that. There's the three power things. And it will go back just like that. So Just remember, because it does matter, actually. Oh, look at that. The dampener is still on there. Are they... These pieces are still on there, so I gotta figure out how to get that out. Okay, I'll worry about that in a second. But that's something that you need to take out, is the dampener. Now, it comes with four dampeners, and it's only got two of these things, and that's normal. So when you see that, don't think anything of it. Before I reattach this, I'm gonna take these out. Because I'm obviously not gonna reuse these ones because they're done for. See, there's a little washer. Maybe this is how I should have done it in the first place. There's a little washer right here that if you just remove the washer part, it comes right off. See, so you take the stick out. That's what holds it on, and then you can just pull it out. So, again, push that out. Take off the dampener, or excuse me, the washer thing or whatever, which holds the dampener on to the, I don't know what you call that, the gimbal plate, I guess. And I'm gonna just put that aside. If I wanted to, I could put all four in. If I wanted to, you know, because it uses two, which I guess is enough, or else it would use more. But if I wanted to add extra stability on the dampers, I could just use all four. I wonder if I should leave that on. Well, let's take them all out. Now, I'm going to save these, because these are really brand new. I probably should have just left them in, to be honest. But since there's four new ones in here, I'll go ahead and use them. But these are basically brand new. So I'm gonna save these for backup dampers because Unique didn't send me for backup. So I'll keep those. And now let's reapply everything. First, let's open this guy. And again, it has those are the two things that, you know, are washers and things that hold the dampers on, which you do from the top. And here are my four new dampers. And here is the new plate, which, as you can see, now has, I don't know if you can see it real well, but you see how it has tracking now that will hold the gimbal in place, or will hold the mounting in place, as opposed to this one that has, excuse me, that has nothing, because it had a little, but as I was trying to put it on, it went to nothing. So that's not going to hold it in place. That will. So let's lay this guy back down and reattach. Attach the slides so it slides in so easily. So you can see that it's perfect. I mean, you can't get it wrong because it slides in, like it just clicks into place. And then when I put this guy back on, there's three little spots. So pay attention to where you put your screws because they're real small. Now, I would just finger tight it. I wouldn't make it too tight, and I certainly wouldn't strip it. We're good to go as far as the this is concerned. Now I just need to set the dampeners, which hopefully won't be too difficult. Let me review. I should have left the dampers on the top part. That was stupid to take those off because I just created more work for myself. But hopefully this method that I was taught will proved to be easy. I completely made more work for myself by taking these out of the top. So anyway, this is the method that that I was taught. Now I really have, oh wait, which is there a bottom and a top, or are they all the same? I think they look the same. To put the loop through here, put that through the hole. That's when they came through. Okay, now how do I get rid of this? Well, it worked, but then I'm wrapping this around here. Okay? And then I'm going to pull it through. By just yanking this. Do it there. Oh yeah, that worked like a charm. Did you see that? Perfect. Yay me. All right, so actually thank you to nothing in particular. That worked fantastically. I'm actually majorly surprised. So again, I'm going to wrap that around there. Okay, now this is something that people I've seen when I was watching my videos complain to the point where they stopped working on it because of putting these dampers on. And that method worked really well, and I've never done this before, so I wrap it around there, put it in the hole. I should use the shorter one and make it actually easier. I don't need this much. Pull it through. Bam. Love when stuff works. All right, so far so good. Now let me do on the other side. Okay, again, going to wrap the damper with the twisty tie. I now feel very confident in this method. I suppose if you want to replace all four dampers, you have to do this first. You have to remove the top ones. I didn't really need to, so I wish I didn't, because I'm just creating more work for myself again. But I have to get a move on because I need to pick up my daughter from school, so that works so nicely. I will then take the fourth one. It wasn't getting power due to if it gets power, that will be definitely the reason. I mean, even when I turn it on, even before I turn on the camera, as long as I know I get power, I know it's working. Now, what I want to do is if I was to place this using the arrow, I could see that would be the front of my camera. And hopefully it will now line up well. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the dampers, or excuse me, the damper clips. Whatever you call these things. And these are different. These washers are different. This whole thing is different. I don't think it makes a difference, but his are circular and mine are like these things that I guess clip on like this. So I'm going to take it and I'm going to line it up. Now, if you're only going to use two, you want to be diagonal. You want to use the opposite sides diagonally. Okay, so I just placed that in there. Now I want to work it through. Oh, this looks pretty easy. So I just placed that in there. Now you see the difference? These are a different size altogether. This is the old one, and the new one is like the size of the actual whole thing here. I don't know if it's a different part now or what, but instead of having to work in, it almost seems easier. Because you see now, when I press it in, when I press it in, it just pops out here. And then I just have to take use my screwdriver to push it through a little bit. Now I just need to take, where is it? Just need to take this thing. It's like a washer, and snap it on. Oh dear, that didn't work. All right, all FPV DIYers that are laughing at me now, stop. I've never done this before. I've never even attempted to try and do anything like this before, as small as this is. There we go. Okay, got it. Or what I didn't do was pull all of these in before I did this ass backwards, like an idiot. I didn't put the dampers. I should have pulled the dampers through first. Hopefully it's gonna be easy to do now that I've got that part in, because like an idiot, I didn't pull the dampers through first. Oh God, so you know what? I've gotta take that part off and redo that whole thing, because I'm a moron. Okay. Good. Sort of got lucky there. So what I just did was I actually started to put the pieces on to connect it before actually pulling the dampers through on this, which is what you should do first. So just like we did on the other piece, you wanna wrap it around. Don't pull it, just, you know, don't wrap it around more than once, just enough so that you can get it through. Wrap it around good there. What if I just actually brought it here instead, like even lower? Remember, don't tighten it so that it won't let go once it's through. Or else then you're giving yourself more work. Something that you can see I am very good at doing. Come on, get through. All right. This is a lot more simple than I'm making it look. That's because I'm nervous because I don't do this stuff. Maybe it's easier. Bazam. All right, almost there, halfway. And the twisting it, forget everything I said before, twisting it is a way to go. It didn't occur to me that that it's not gonna be that tight that it won't just let loose. My little twisty tie is starting to get too twisted. So actually, yeah, just kind of do it tight. That actually worked better. And send it through. Don't start pulling too hard until you are close to the actual plate. Come on, get through. Yeah. I'm more proud of myself than you guys think I am. Well, you guys are laughing at me. I'm actually proud of myself. Oh, just pulled it out of the bottom one. Dang it. So while you're doing this, be careful you don't pull it out of the bottom one. Dang it. Oh no, that's gonna be really. I'm gonna tell myself that that wasn't on good enough in the first place, which part it didn't seem like it was going to be until now. Okay, come on, get through. Yay, all right. And there you have it. Now I just gotta put the, should just line right up now and slide on like it normally would. It does, yeah, lovely. Awesome. Okay, now let me. So, we're gonna take, see these just, these washers, this is a new kind of system. Instead of, you guys don't need to see that. So, all you do is you push it through and it just sticks out right there. It's real simple. I made it real hard. Should just connect. There we go, yeah. Okay, so there, I have it. You see, there's the, there's one side. What the? Why did the washers come? No! Okay, so these came out. I don't know why. I guess I didn't have them in good. That really blows. I thought I had these in good, but they just came out while I was doing that. So now I've got to put them on again, and hopefully I can do it well. Let me just cut these. It's smaller. It's easier when it's smaller. Very careful, guys, because, again, wires. Okay, something that I wasn't doing before that I am doing now is I'm twisting it. Because it will pull off anyway. Now I've got less leeway to play with. Okay, so since I put one dampening washer on this side, I'm going to put the other one on this side, and then I'm going to add the other ones later. Because I'm going to add four. Just to keep it nice and sturdy. Made a nice snap. Okay. Now I've got it working. So now the test. Let me put on, oh, well first let's put the mount back on. What was the front, what was the back? let me see. So, all right, so there, and now I've got it all on finally. I'm going to place the cap back on, and the blank part goes in the, what would be the front. So that goes on there. And oh, that didn't sound very nice. Oh, that was just the gimbal clamp. Okay. So now I'm gonna put the gimbal on and see if it works. If I get power at all, that means that I have fixed it because it was lit before. So let me flip it on. Now, when you line it up, you wanna make sure that everything is lined up properly so that you're break it again. There we go. Okay. Feels like it's on good. I think it's on right. I'm gonna take the gimbal cover off. And I will turn on the bird and let's see if the gimbal goes on. The gimbal goes on at all, which it is, I have fixed it. Yippee. See if it calibrates. All right. And there you have it, folks. It works.